Chemistry is a really old discipline, and you always use what's come before you. So you build on what's known and you try and add to that collection of knowledge. When you thaw it and it's a liquid, you'll see all the bubbles come out, yep, out of the solution and it'll be in the top. You can put on a reaction expecting that you're going from A to B. Instead you get C. You start to wonder, how did we get to C and how can we use that? And it's about always capitalising on those unexpected things. That's where all the nice discoveries are made. Love of design, I think, transitioned into a love for science in general, but in particular chemistry. I did chemistry with pharmacology, so I was always interested in the shapes of molecules, the design of molecules and how they worked. I liked making things. I liked actually stuffing things up too. So it was sort of about, why did that fail right from way back then? And why did somebody get a better yield than me? Okay, how can I change that? So it was it's a very competitive chemistry. I've worked on proteins that are responsible for why insects can hover and plunge and jump, called resilin. I've worked on turning canola oil into monomers for nylon synthesis, so you don't need to get it from petroleum anymore. We grew the program into tackling some marine conotoxin molecules, which come from cone snails, and these are very potent analgesics. And each time a new target was taken on, the complexity of the structure increased. And so we found ourselves then looking at insulin, which is quite a complicated molecule to make.
And we're going to have a catalysis meeting.
Insulin is unstable at high temperatures, which makes transport around the globe to diabetes patients very, very challenging. And when you need to get insulin into remote places or into countries that don't have refrigeration, it means that you compromise the care that you'll give to those patients.
Okay.
And then when we make this insulin molecule, it's about piece by piece putting the amino acids together. We have to do that to get to a molecule that has 51 pieces. And it needs to have these three bridges constructed in just the right way, or else the molecule won't have the right three-dimensional shape. So once you've got that molecule, you then test it, and all the testing shows that it functions just like insulin. It doesn't cause cancer. It causes glucose uptake. It doesn't form long fibres which can block pumps, and it's stable to 90 degrees, so it's a beautiful molecule. Our insulin journey started 10 years ago. We never thought that we would be at the junction that we're at now, so we have some molecules that have outstanding properties, far better than many that are on the market. A little bit through luck, but most definitely through a lot of hard work. Chemistry is an art, and you need to have a thorough understanding of your discipline in order to make the molecules and design the way that you'll construct the molecules. But it's really the creative process of really asking what could be possible. It's the imagination that really drives you and makes you question, what can you contribute and how does that work and how can we make that better? And that's the constant driver. There's enough going on in chemistry to sustain many lifetimes, so I don't see myself giving out on chemistry for a long time.